There's something about the women-oriented films, especially the ones where the lead characters tries to rise above their mundane life and achieve something good. Most of these women are sari-clad and from middle class who have given up their dreams or their career just to nurture their marriage or their kids. Designer sarees and cliche aparts, whether it is English Winglish or the recently released Tumhari Sullu, most of these women characters are very well written, endearing and highly relatable. And that is something where Tumhari Sullu excels. Tumhari Sullu is a story of a peppy Sullu, very excellently portrayed by Vidya Balan, who is full of fun and has zest for life. She is not so ordinary woman, but with ordinary dreams. All that she wants is to carve a niche for herself, get acknowledged and get her act right. Whether it's participating in a lemon or spoon race or playing random radio contest, Sullu has a winning streak in her, and spite of all the stereotypes around her, she continues on following what she likes. She loves her family, which includes her son and adorable husband. She is a woman that you and I will love to meet, love to be friends with, a woman that may not be as rare but highly relatable. I don't know why, but I could relate to Sullu in ways more than one. Call it the storytelling or the power-packed performance by Vidya Balan, who creaselessly brings the joys and emotion of the middle-class housewife. Vidya Sullu is ably supported by Manav, called Ashok, who is a super doting husband. I'm sure that after watching this movie, a lot of sensible girls would like to have a husband like him. Ashok is a simple, down-to-earth guy who is eternally smitten by his wife. He manages a stressful job at a Lalaji firm, but plays a perfect host to his wife's family and a perfect husband to his wife without showing any signs of male egos, in spite of the fact when his wife decides to embark on an altogether different kind of career path, which is like playing a sari wali bhabi doing late night radio shows. In between, blame it on the turn of events like a bad career phase, he gets a bit perturbed, including, you know, all the different lewd comments he hears about his wife's profession from here and there, but he soon understands the folly, rises above the mediocre and hearts her back. He may not be an Ivy League educated guy speaking just English or living a hi-fi life, but he is high on life, even if that means changing bed sheets or singing Batta Tawara with his wife. Ain't that lovely? Another fantabulous performance to watch out for. And then there are other interesting characters, including Sullu's unempathetic twin sisters, her colleagues at radio station, and a very affable boss, Neha Dhupia. Neha Dhupia is another delight factor in this film. She has a small but a very significant role to play, which she plays with aplomb. And if you are able to keep away ogling at her style sense, you may be able to see a very nice, sober and subtle performance there. The music is so, except the soundtrack to Banja Meri Rani, which is definitely gonna be a hit in the car radios and the pubs. One of my favorite scenes in this movie, where Sulochana very ably settles a piece of a collar while peeling some green peas and giving him examples of aloo matar and matar paneer. That's quite a tongue twister. Overall, Tumhari Sullu has a very peppy first half and not so peppy second half. Very hurried climax, but a very good performance by all the lead actors. It is a must-watch film. Go ahead and book yourself a ticket to watch it with your friend, your family, your spouse, especially your girlfriend, boyfriend. So what are you waiting for? Go ahead and watch this movie. But before that, do not forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the like button if you have liked this video. Thank you once again for watching my videos. Take care until next video. Ciao. That's sweet.